Nearly 5 years after the Grenfell Tower disaster highlighted the danger of flammable cladding, the potentially deadly material is still on hundreds of buildings right across the state. The review has found the official response has been inefficient and inconsistent.
The concourse in Chatswood, fresh from a $7 million renovation to remove flammable panels.
So the cladding across the entire building has now been replaced with cladding that is compliant, and it represents Willoughby Council's commitment to this important community asset.
While the show can now safely go on, it's not in the majority.
More than 50% of the dangerous flammable cladding that was on buildings 5 years ago is still there, and that's because the government hasn't coordinated a proper response.
The Auditor-General has examined the state's response and found identifying combustible cladding has been complex, resource-intensive and inefficient, principally due to the lack of centralised and coordinated building records. The good news is it is now likely that most high-risk buildings have been identified. The not-so-good? Remediation is slow-going. 60% of the 1,200 buildings referred to councils are still to be assessed, while half of the 66 state-owned buildings have been rectified. And as we reported last month, no cladding has yet been removed from apartments under Project Remediate, a billion-dollar government scheme providing interest-free loans to pay for the work. However, these figures don't give the whole story. They only deal with buildings classified as high risk. There are still hundreds more which may require costly rectification works. The report reveals there is no process for clearing buildings other than those in the high risk category. 536 buildings have been deemed low risk, a classification that may be misleading if taken in an everyday sense. It does not equate to no risk.
No work has been done on those buildings that were identified as low risk.
The government was approached for comment. Lachlan Kennedy for 10 News First.